This is my previous graph that worked on adding accumulating distances since frame 0 into an array through a map function. It was working, but as at the unfortunate thing that even though at early on the animation max frame rate was quite high, and the actual time scrubbing works well, but once we get in very deep in the animation, max frame rate falls down. And the reason is because I'm calculating values since frame 0 to be able to calculate the actual trajectory that the reference object did to calculate the proper rotation. So I decided to change the way the graph worked and came up with this graph here that works on cache. So I'm using cache and getting the actual only getting the current cache value to calculate the distance between current and last frame. And the cache update here does an add on the actual the previous value and the new one and keeps accumulating. So that's the accumulating value over time. Added some time tracking feature for playback, real-time playback, some following. And the rest is the same over here. Well, I've added also not to divide by zero whenever I'm on frame zero here, so it doesn't generate an infinite rotation. And that's that had the pretty cool side effect that not only do we have a relatively good playback scrum timeline, we have a relatively high frame rate early on the animation, as well as near 9,000, 10,000 frames, because I'm not recalculating since the beginning of time. Well, the actual rotation matches, efficiency of the graph is higher. Frame rate max is much better. And I can come back at any place in time and just drag it through. I can forward like that, It's always on spot. And this method still works with in space. So even though if the wheels move in space, the cache using does not alter that. So that still works as I would expect. So I'm quite happy with this new wheel solver, as it is very efficient.